Hello students, now today I am going to start a new chapter, motion. But first of all we will discuss about moving objects and stationary objects. Now moving objects are those objects which can change their position with respect of time, like a moving car, a moving bus or a moving bicycle. But stationary objects are those which do not change their position with time. मीन्स टाइम बीतने के साथ भी वो अपनी जगह पर ही रहते हैं, उनकी पोजीशन में कोई चेंज नहीं होता. वी कैन टेक एग्जांपल दैट अ बिल्डिंग, एन इलेक्ट्रिक पोल और अ ट्री, ऑल दीज आर द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ स्टेशनरी ऑब्जेक्ट. नाउ टू स्टडी मोर अबाउट मोशन एंड मूविंग ऑब्जेक्ट्स वी शुड नो द मीनिंग ऑफ टू मेन वर्ड्स दैट आर डिस्टेंस एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट. सो डिस्टेंस, डिस्टेंस क्या होता है? एक्चुअल लेंथ ऑफ द पाथ विच इज कवर्ड बाय अ मूविंग ऑब्जेक्ट्स irrespective of the direction in which it is moving, that is known as the distance. Now with the help of the figure we will understand that how we can measure the distance. Here I have shown the path with the dotted lines. Suppose a man is moving from his house, that is at point A, to the bank, that is at point B, and after that he moves to his office, that is at point C. So if we want to calculate the distance covered by him, we can easily calculate that 6 km and that 6 km added to these 3 km, which will give us 9 km. It means the distance covered by the man, that is 9 km. Now with the help of same figure we can easily find out that what is the displacement. But before that we should know that what is initial point and what is final point. Now initial point means from where the motion is starting or the movement is starting. So here A is initial point, and the point where the motion or movement ends, that is known as final point. So here C is final point. Now we can easily find out the displacement between A and C. चलिए अब समझते हैं displacement क्या होता है. So when a body is moving from one position to another, the shortest distance between its initial point and final point along with the direction, that is known as displacement. So in this figure mein the man has started from initial point A, and after covering this distance he reached at point C, that is final point. So yahan par displacement ho jayega, the shortest distance between A and C, initial point and final point. And with the same figure we can easily find out the displacement of the person from home to its office. Now here the initial point is A and the final point is C. So displacement is the shortest distance between point A and point C. Suppose on measuring if it comes 5 km, it means displacement in this case is 5 km. But one thing you should keep in mind that displacement always go with direction. So yahan sirf 5 km nahi likhenge, displacement kis direction mein ho raha hai, that is also required. So when we represent displacement it should be like this, that 5 km in east direction or towards east. So that is also one major difference between distance and displacement. In distance only magnitude is required, but when we represent displacement, when we talk about displacement, direction also go along with the magnitude. So these type of physical quantities where direction is also required with the magnitude and unit, that type of physical quantities are known as vector quantities. Means displacement is a vector quantity, क्योंकि हमें यहाँ पर direction भी add करना पड़ता है, direction भी show करना पड़ता है. जबकि distance, जहाँ पर हमें direction show नहीं करना पड़ता, that type of physical quantities are known as scalar quantities.